Hi, this is Nick Barrett from Pendragon, and you are listening to Live Prog. No, you are watching Live Prog.
Certain bands that I would love to review, and sometimes you get the chance, like in this video review, and I don't have to say which band, of course. Yes, this one, the brand new Queensrÿche album. Of course, the band has been followed at the moment by a lot of controversy. There's a lot of discussions going on. They broke up with Jeff Tate, they have a new singer, you have two Queensrÿche now, right now, both having an album out, very confusing and everything, very distracting as well. Let's make it clear, we are talking about this album. This is the band Queensrÿche with Todd La Torre. That's the new singer. In the accompanying press sheet that I got with the album, it said that Todd La Torre is not just a singer, but he's also a drummer. So he's also a musician, so he can also relate to the musical aspects of the songs and of the album. He used to be the singer in Crimson Glory. He joined the band after Midnight, the original singer of Crimson Glory, passed away. I haven't heard him with Crimson Glory. This is the first time I heard him on this album, the self-titled Queensrÿche album. Self-titled, that's something I always used to say, you know, the album does not have a title, which I still think is a bit funny. I mean, a lot of bands do it. I never get it. I mean, why not give the album a title? It's much easier to, you know, tell you what album you're talking about. But of course, minor detail, we have it here, Queensrÿche. When I got it, the first thing I did was listen to it and listen to the vocals, because I was really curious how Todd La Torre would sound on this album. Now, I gotta say, it was a pleasant surprise, because he sounded phenomenal. He is a fantastic singer. He has a very powerful voice, a very wide range in his singing. So, listening to the album, vocal-wise, absolutely fantastic. That said, I gotta be honest, when I was listening to him singing, he did remind me of Jeff Tate, especially in the early days. And I think, you know, Operation Mindcrime era. That kind of passion and power that Queensrÿche had back then, that is what you hear on this album as well. And that is good, because it kind of feels like the fire has been rekindled. The band is rejuvenated again. They're enthusiastic again, you know, because when I listen to this album, the band feels very tight. They're very one big unity, one well-oiled machine, including Todd La Torre. And they are on a roll here with this album. They're really having something fantastic here, something that people can enjoy listening. And that is why you buy an album. You don't buy an album because of a controversy. You buy an album because you want to have something to listen to, something that will entertain you and that will enjoy you. Well, this album will entertain you. This album will definitely enjoy you.
Reaction against control, the corporate stranglehold, tear down the walls of fantasy. Be willing to surrender what you are for what you could become. Altering your destiny.
Of course, when you say Queensrÿche, you say Operation Mindcrime, because that is, well, a phenomenal album that put the band on the map, that is one of the greatest rock operas or concept albums we know. Then you have Empire, and I remember when I was a little guy, Empire, I went to the record store and asked for that, and they had a single out called Silent Lucidity. The guy at the counter, when I put them on for me to listen to, he said, you know, be careful, this is a heavy album, you know, not just that song, that's the only soft song, but the rest is a very heavy album. Well, I love that very much. And I've seen the band having up and downs throughout the years, making great albums, making, well, maybe lesser albums. And despite the fact that they have this controversy at this moment, which must be very distracting for the band, this album, what they bring now, sounds fantastic. As I said, it sounds like a well-oiled machine. There's a lot of chemistry between the band and the singer Todd La Torre. So, you know, they really found each other, and it turns out to be a fantastic match. And I hope that they will carry on for a long time, making a lot more music. Despite the fact that it is a short album, it's only 35 minutes, but it's 35 minutes filled with amazing music. Well, there are two, well, maybe one track that you know, don't really do something for me. That's Midnight Lullaby. I think that's sort of a filler track. I don't know why they put it on there. The first track, X2, what the album opens with, is sort of instrumental ambient thing that moves into the first real track, Where Dreams Go to Die. And when that track starts, you know, again, I mentioned Operation Mindcrime a couple of times because, as I said, the sound of the band, and especially with singer La Torre, when I listen to this album, it kind of takes me back to that era, to that Operation Mindcrime era. In my mind, in my fantasy, it is like this is the album the band made after Operation Mindcrime. You know, that's the kind of sound they bring on this album. And I love the drums in this album, especially on that first track, Where Dreams Go to Die, by Scott Rockenfield. Really fantastic. I love it. And throughout the album, he is very good. He makes a rock solid combination with bass player Eddie Jackson, giving the songs a really solid foundation that the rest of the band can build on. Songs that kind of stand out for me. They really, when I listen to them, it's like, wow, this is awesome. This is really fantastic. Redemption and Vindication. These are really fantastic heavy songs, but here we have a really glorious part from Michael Wilton and Parker Lundgren, the two guitar players in the band, because there are amazing solos in there, really crunchy riffs, and I love that very much. And that is the sound. Those songs are, for me, what this band is all about. You know, that is... they are fantastic songs, and again, with the vocals and with the rhythm section, makes them just perfect. At the same time, I have the feeling that the band is still playing a bit on safe. They have some AOR influences in the music, especially in the first couple of tracks, but as the album goes on, you know, they really like a sort of a diesel engine. You know, at the halfway of the album, they are on fire and they keep on going. And unfortunately, you know, after half an hour, the album is done, so all you can do is, you know, hit play again and listen to the album again. I did that a lot. I listened to this album really very much, and I gotta say, it sounds fantastic to me. The production, of course, if we look at who helped out the band with the production, Jim Barton, you know, he's a great guy. He did a lot of good work. He did a lot of good work on this album as well. So what comes out of the speakers sounds fantastic, but it's not just the producer. It is what the band brings. The band feels very good working together with each other, and that's what I like. And despite the distracting things that are going on outside of their music, you know, I'm really impressed that they still came up with such a good album. And despite the fact that it is not that long, it is very good. And I say they are on the right musical path. I just hope that they will continue this line, continue this sound, and continue working with Todd La Torre, because he's a fantastic singer. And I can't wait to have another Queensrÿche album in my hands, hopefully under the name Queensrÿche. But you know, even if it is not that name, but these guys, I will still buy it for sure, and I will still review it on liveprog and promote it just as much as this one, because they make fantastic music, because they are amazing musicians. So do yourself a favor, check out this album, Queensrÿche, the self-titled one, listen to it, buy it, support these guys, and as I said, you know, I really hope that they will bring more, a lengthier album next time, where we can enjoy the band a lot more. I hope you enjoyed this video review. On liveprog.com you find more video reviews, but also interview specials and a lot more. You can subscribe to this YouTube channel and follow all the new video reviews I release. And also, of course, follow me on Facebook or Twitter and stay up to date to the world of liveprog.